I'm just showing you at the moment the compliance statement that we always show you. We're required to show you this ask you to read it, pay attention to it, it's important. Here is the contact details for any of you that want free trials of anything that we have. You can contact Terry at support@thedanielcode.com if you'd like a free trial of any of the Daniel Code material. He'll switch you on to everything. You can have your trial and sort out for yourself what of our product is suitable for you. We can also arrange free trials of Trade Navigator software and charting program. So if that interests you, do contact Terry, please. Okay, so let's move on to the important part of the business. What we're going to want to do to start with is look at some of our six-day charts. Now, the ones we're going to look at, I was going to cover the Australian market anyway, and then I had a specific request. One of you kindly emailed me and said, could I cover it? And that was Peter Townsend. So, Peter, this is what you asked for, and the code for that market, folks, is AP. That's the futures market, this market is the futures contract that tracks the ASX, or the Australian Stock Exchange, the 200 largest companies, and it's now called the S&P 200, this contract. It used to be the All Ordinaries Index. Bill Dalywell's here with us. Hi, Bill. I sent you a note. I'm going to talk to you on the phone late today. So this is a very important market, and in many ways it's a bellwether for international markets. Australia is about the fifth or sixth largest economy in the world, and it's an interesting economy because it's had something like 30 or 40 years of pretty much uninterrupted growth. It's a country that's incredibly rich in minerals, have the largest iron ore deposits in the world, the largest coal deposits in the world, the largest uranium deposits in the world, a whole lot of diamonds, which are not terribly commercially significant, and some of the best grazing and beef fattening and sheep country in the world. And the old story used to be that Australia rides on the sheep's back, and that's pretty much gone now. The sheep industry is nothing like what it used to be. When I was a really young man, sheep wool was £1 a pound. Australia had pounds in those days rather than dollars as we do now, and a pound of sheep's wool was worth a pound. It was a lot of money, a pound in those days. But the cattle's big here. But the mining, uranium, iron ore in particular, you've got Rio here and BHP, of course, the two of the three largest miners in the world, along with Vale or Vale. And then we have the most massive coal deposits. And basically what these illustrious companies do, along with a few others, is rip the iron ore out of the ground. Helen's over there in West Australia. Actually, her son was involved in this business, worked for one of the big mining companies well north of Perth. She'd know all about it. And what these companies do is they rip the iron ore out of the ground and rip the coal out of the ground, and that's exported well, this is interesting. Excuse me, Peter Townsend saying no, it's not me. Well, I have an email from Peter Townsend, p7townsend@gmail.com. If that's not you, I'm sorry. ASX 200, can you give me a quick synopsis on the ASX 200 for the rest of the year? Anyway, that's what I'm doing. So it's an important market. And in addition to that, Australia has a massive natural gas industry in Queensland and off the northwest shelf of Western Australia. And I think we either are or are about to become the biggest natural gas exporters in the world. So what's happening is in this commodity crash, if you like, iron ore is down from 117, 118 dollars a ton down to less than 50. I think we're down to 46, 47. It bounced a little bit now. Oil's very much at depressed prices, and of course, natural gas is to quite a marked degree also tied to the price of oil as an alternate energy. So, tie that in with a whole lot of mismanagement on budgetary issues, and you have the capacity to say, well, we're going to be facing some problems, and I think we are. And the charts, as soon as I can just open this to make sure you're all on the right chart, which you are. You can see that this chart is actually starting us to tell something. This is the old lows down here. This is the 2009 March lows. This market bottomed when the US markets did, and it's been running up this broad Daniel Code trading channel all the way through. And then, if you follow me, see if I can get my highlighting tool, which I think is easier for you to see. Spotlight, they call it, don't they? Here we had this break between. There's the one standard deviation line running up there. We had the breakdown below that to a two standard deviation line, and from there we've started another Daniel Code trading channel. And these are what defines our trends for us. And you can see this market's been moving beautifully up here. It's held support at one standard deviation. It's been on to the upper one standard deviation, running along the median, break down below the one standard deviation, recovered, and here we are. We popped up above the one standard deviation. I'll just bring that down a bit so we can see it more easily. Here we are. We ran up. I'll just make this bigger for you folks. We ran up exactly to the top of this new channel, and we had an expiring Daniel Code time cycle there, and this market's now dropped down just this week. It must have known what I was going to say, and it's at one standard deviation from the mean now. Remember that these lines are not fixed for all time. They move as the median moves. So these breaks down here were not apparent. This close below one standard deviation was not there when the trading channel was back there. But we now have this market poised right at one standard deviation from its very, very long-term trading channel. And it's been in this secondary channel now since August 2011. So it's incredible how accurate these things are. I think it's the most underused tool in the Daniel Code library. And I'm going to, in the second half of this webinar, I'm going to show you some better ways of trading that you can do by using this tool. So, what we're looking out for there is that the that trading channel there is at 5991, I suspect. 5.5 looks like it's there's the low of the bars close enough to it. 5.559, and if we get a close below that, this bar expires on Monday. But if in the next couple of weeks we get a close below that lower one standard deviation, which seems likely, and if this budget's not well received, we certainly will. And if we get a close below that that doesn't immediately reverse, we're going to start assuming that there's a change of trend. And that's going to have repercussions for other indices elsewhere. So we really, for the first time, for a long time, start to go on high alert to look at this chart. It's going to tell us a lot, and being a smaller economy, it's going to be much more sensitive to these sort of fiscal issues we've got. And I expect it to be a bit of a canary in the coal mine to tell us what's coming down the track. The next chart we're going to look at, these are all on the six-day trading charts, guys, which is the most sensitive of the long-term charts, and we follow these pretty carefully. And what we have here, we've now moved, this is the S&P index. This is the dollar SPX. This code up here tells you this is the index of the S&P, which is often better than the futures. And it's done much the same sort of thing. You can see that all the time since March 2009, this market has run inside the Daniel Code trading channel. You've probably seen this chart hundreds of times. I try to get you to review it periodically because it's very easy in our day-to-day trading and dealing with the issues we have to deal with that we lose sight of the big picture. That's why I'd like to get you to think about these things. And then in here, almost as a mirror image of the Australian market, we had a low that broke through one standard deviation and went exactly to two standard deviations. And we then put on our second standard deviation. And from there, we started another Daniel Code trading channel. And it's the one here in black. And you can see this is the, I get my headlight for you, spotlight, I think it's called. Here it is. This solid black line here is the median, and this lighter line underneath, excuse me, is one standard deviation from the mean. That's one Daniel Code standard deviation from the mean. If you're putting these on your charts, don't forget to set your standard deviation at 1.593. If you leave it at one or two, it's meaningless. You have to use the Daniel Code ratios to get these things to talk to you. So it's wandered along there, and you can see that it's just been oscillating happily between the upper standard deviation, lower standard deviation, wandering along the mean all the time. But we've had a little bit of a change in the performance there. So what we can see now is there was our last close above the mean, which is it should just be oscillating around the mean if it's not showing any real volatility, and that was back in December. Those of you who follow Daniel Code remember that in March 2014 I said this market should be at 2100 by December. In fact, its high on this market was 2093. It was 7 points away and only about 3-4 points away on the futures. And that 2100 has proved to be a number that has had a pretty profound effect on this chart. And the reason for that, as David Webb would tell you, who's the king of the black lines, is a good friend of mine who's been to a tutorial, maybe been to two, Webby, I'm not sure, but he is always terribly aware of what the black lines do, which is the Daniel 89% retracement. That's the last level of support or resistance within an operating swing. So we said the 2100 was going to be an important number way back in March 2014. Well, use a bit of poetic license and let's say that from December on, this market has been oscillating around that 2100, which is black line resistance to any future upside. More importantly than that, you can see that there's been a subtle change in the behavior of this market, that instead of it oscillating around the mean, which is its normal behavior, see that all the way back, up and down, up and down. It has not been above the mean since, you know, way back here. And we've had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 14, 15 or 16 odd weeks of this different behavior now. In fact, we haven't been above the mean since December. All of this work is there, and it's now starting to hang around and break the lows of the one standard deviation. It did that back here on this bar. It appears to be the other bar, but that wasn't below the one standard deviation at the time, remembering these Daniel Code trading channels are dynamic and move as they're moved along here. But we did get a close right on it, but immediately recovered. And we can now see that we've had two closes, three closes now below that. We really want to see that recover pretty quickly, or we're going to start having the default assumption that the trend has changed. There's not enough evidence to show us that yet, but we're certainly starting to look much more critically at the positioning of this market. So there's two things to keep an eye out on. Our next market to have a look at is oil. Who asked for oil? Rod Hawkins, hello mate, asked to have a look at oil. They'd like to know what it's doing. Here it is. Here's oil. It's been pretty spectacular. We had the big run up and long periods up here of $109, $110, and it went sideways for a very long time. And eventually we got the break just after the middle of last year, and down it's gone. So it's run through all the support, and it, we had 42.29 was the Daniel Code black line on this chart, and it ran down there. It flirted with the red line. This is the fourth seal line. It hit that, bounced away, hit down, closed on it again, ran down, a little bit of rally back up to the median, and now it made its last push down and stopped short of the Daniel Code black line, but not very short. The low of that bar was 42.85 against the black line at 42.49, which is not a great difference. Not a great difference on a six-day chart. And in fact, this bar way back here in January this year, end of January, that's the momentum low. You can see two things on charts. You can see the momentum high-low and the chart high-low. So that's actually the lowest close of the bar. That is the momentum low, way back there, right on the fourth seal where it should have been. And this is the chart low, which very quickly snapped back and reversed itself. So then we got a nice rally. Where would it go? Well, it's gone pretty well to the Daniel Code retracement. I'll just put the numbers on this. I'm pretty sure that it's the 29 retracement. There it is. That's the minimum amount that a market can retrace, and it's weakened as it's approached that. This is not a sign of strength, even though we've had a decent rally through here. This is not a sign of strength. We'd have to see much higher prices before we thought anything too dramatic was going to happen in the way of higher oil prices here. We can now put a new trading channel on here. You can start the trading channel either from the chart low or the closing low before it. So we've got a number of options. We can draw it from there, which is the closing low, and we can see that market is starting to march up a channel. It's getting towards the top of it. And there's the first, that's the smallest Daniel Code retracement. Fast markets, what I call fast markets, retrace 29%, then 37.5%. If that is all it can retrace, it's going to go down further and probably take out those lows. So while people in the business are very happy, the producing side of the business are very happy that price is rallying, and motorists are much less happy, that is not anything that at this stage looks like anything more than a corrective rally. So we expect sideways to further down, and we'd want to see quite a few of these levels here penetrated before we thought a low was in on oil. Our next market to look at, of course, as always, is gold. That's always important to a lot of you. We have a very complex chart here. with lots of stuff on it. Let me make it a whole lot easier for you to see. It's pretty nice. We tracked this market all the way down. We got our low right at a fourth seal line. This is back now in November 2014, where it hit the fourth seal line on the 62 cycle, which is usually support. It rallied up straight into a Daniel Code price retracement up there. Then it worked its way down, got support on the black line. Remember, the black line is the only one of our retracement numbers that tends to work more on the close of the bar than on the bar high low. All the others work on the bar high low or the close. The black line has a definite preference for the close. So that market ran down, pierced the black line, said, oops, sorry, that was a mistake, and rallied up to hit the 50% line right there with a degree of precision. 12.24.50. The Daniel Code retracement level was just two ticks away from that. And since then, it's pretty well gone sideways. So we're seeing more consolidation here. I'm not, technically, the trend is still up on this move from the low, but I'm not seeing any great enthusiasm in this market. And the reason I would be concerned about this market is that if there is a big tip out in the equity indices, there are a whole lot of traders who keep their resources and some assets in gold. And very often, if there are margin calls, you will see gold sold off to fulfill those margin calls. So this line here, our latest line for now, is holding. You get a little down your hedgehog there and put the last set of retracements on this swing. And you can see that it's gone through the 59. We can take all these other ones off. And it looks like it's, we'll put the 89 on. And it's sort of got sloppy support off the 62, which is 1172.70. And the previous bar did that as well. Now, the 62 is just a parking zone, 62% retracement. There are two Fibonacci numbers close to the Daniel Code numbers. One is the 28 and the other is 61.8, which is close to the Daniel Code number of 62.5. And it's a sort of a sloppy number. When the markets miss the 59.3 and get to the 62.5, it's really telling you that there's no conviction in the market at all. The market makers are just looking for somewhere to park it. And that's what you see here. So at the moment, as long as it holds that level, doesn't close below it, we can still assume the trend is up. But beware, if we do get a break in the US equity markets in particular, we could see gold sold off to satisfy margin calls. That's what happens. Our next market to look at is the Aussie dollar. One of you has stuck a message in saying, I assume I'm going to do the euro. I'll show you some of the euro stuff. But I haven't really prepared to do the euro today, James, but I can do that for you at the next tutorial. Here's the Aussie dollar, which had this spectacular run up from 2008 up into 2011. And this is all to do with the Australian mining boom, with very loose settings by the Labor Party, massive deficits being run. It then went sideways, and until eventually we got a break just after April 2013. And what's it done? Well, you have two main swings in here. For those of you who follow this stuff, just bear in mind that there's two swings. There's the major swing down there, which we can show you, and we can make that look. It can we can make it a dashed line for this purpose. And there's another swing just before it, and that's right here. And that's called the penultimate swing. It's the last swing before the low. And it's very important that you identify that because markets will often use that. So we have two separate swings, which is why we have two separate sets of numbers running down here. So this market ran down it stopped. You'd have to bring some more data in to this here. There's the penultimate number one, penultimate number two. This is the penultimate swing. This is the retracement of the major previous operating range, which is at 74.93. And let me bring some of that back for you. There we are. And this market ran down until it found 74.93. And we had, those of you who follow this stuff might remember, we had a red line. We had a fourth seal line right at this low here, which was the momentum low. I took that off. I was doing some work with a client during the week, that's where it got to. So in any event, it found support at the black line of that swing, and look where it rallied to. This is the 59% black line off the major swing that runs all the way down here. So when markets have gone past, and you know, it found this pretty attractive, it had one, two, three periods on this 8071 number, broke through and went back, and now it's testing it from the downside. The other thing that I think is fascinating, if we go all the way back here, you can see in May 2010, we had three bars. This is a six-day chart. So that's 18 days. There's 18 trading days. There's only 22 trading days usually in a month. So the best part of a month, this market hit this line with absolute precision. 80, the lows there, 80, 81. The number here, we're looking for 80, 71. This one just held right on it. And these three bars, very, very close. The point is, this line wasn't on the chart then because this line is created from this high. So way back in April 2010, this market was telling us that there was strong support at that level, but we weren't aware of that until after this high was in place, and we knew it was a high, which means somewhere along here, 2012, January, early 2012, which is, 18 months later. But the chart knew it, even though we didn't. And if you look at that, it's quite extraordinary, isn't it? So this is a bit in the same situation. Yes, we're getting a rally. It's a weak rally. This is basically caused this rally because a lot of things that happen on charts are actually a direct result of government policy. And those of you who follow Australian news at all will understand that the Reserve Bank got round to finally reducing official interest rates to 2% last week. Might have actually been Tuesday of this week. But you can't borrow at 2%. We can't borrow anything like that. Interest rates on mortgages are still hovering around 5% plus. I know that the very cheapest, they think it might be 4.93, but basically it's 5% plus something. And even though at 2%, Australian bonds are at 2.9%, which is incredibly attractive to other central banks where they have zero or negative interest rates. So who's buying these Australian bonds and creating demand for the Australian currency? It's other central banks and very, very big institutions. My best guess is that this market has found perfect support there at the fourth seal and the black line, and it's rallied up. It'll find resistance where it is now. It may go to 82 to the next Daniel Code price level. I then suspect this market is going to go lower. I think things are going to turn bad for Australia. It is the most optimistic country on earth. There are lots of stories I could tell you if we had time. I was in Sydney last week and to see my accountant's end of year stuff. I sat down with a meeting with a room full of accountants and lawyers and doctors, all pretty wealthy, successful people. And they were all 100% invested in the stock market, the Australian stock market primarily. They didn't know what a hedge was. They'd never thought about a hedge. They had no strategy. And these are, really top operators with a lot of money, smart people. They'd never thought of a hedge, and they just blindly accepted that good stocks in these markets just go up forever now. The reality is they pretty much have. And these people have done very, very well with their stock investment, and that just reinforces the bias. But if you've got any contrarian in you at all, as I have, you should really be thinking, boy, when the smart people in the room have thrown aside all caution, when I mean heavily invested, these are smart people. They were telling me about I had to pay for something or other, and used a cash account. They said, "Oh my goodness, you got cash!" And I said, "Well, don't you guys? You probably get paid more than me anyway." "Oh no, you never use cash. You get these special credit cards that, if you pay them in 60 days, you don't have any interest." So they all trade on this free credit that the banks will extend to you. Most of you know that if you pay your credit card within 30 days, there's no interest. And if you're a bit more affluent, the banks are happy to extend that to 60 days. So they're so concerned about their finances that they've all got themselves set up so that every penny can go into either the property market or the stock market. And the Australian property market, according to HSBC, is now the most overpriced and expensive real estate in the world, followed secondly by Switzerland, and a close third is New Zealand. So I think there's enough brewing there to say that if any of the props that are holding this up let go, we could see some fun and drama. And of course, as futures traders, we get paid exactly the same for the downside as the upside, but it usually gets there a whole lot quicker. So just sharpen your antennae. There's nothing there at the moment to have us crying uncle, but there are some signs there, and I wanted to share that with you. They're the major markets that I wanted to show you today. Somebody here, Richard, is desperately asking for the natural gas chart, and I want to get on. I've got a lot of other stuff to show you today, folks. Money making stuff. Here's natural gas. What can we tell from this? We've got an expired couple of things there. There is the blue line that is causing the current take off these ones that are not doing anything at the moment. Let's see where we are. Okay, so there's the blue line, Daniel Code blue line, that's supporting this market. What else can we say about it? It's obviously a while since we looked at it because we don't have any new fourth seal lines on it. Really, this stuff is all sideways. And I guess, as I said, it's had a big crash. It's pretty interesting, this, but this market, that's not a valid trading channel. We need to keep contact with this point up here. As you may recall, those of you who've done these before, and it's now broken through the second standard deviation. So this new trend, the trend is down. So we can put on a new, pretty interesting what happens here, that the price of natural gas, the tradable natural gas, is US gas. And US doesn't have any real exports of, let me move this back and see if we can. That's a valid Daniel Code channel there. We're actually holding on to this hook just before the high on the reverse side of the trading channel. America doesn't export this gas. They have a domestic policy that all or certainly most of it is kept in the country. So you get this very low natural gas price, $2.24. The international price is between $14 and $18. So, if they wanted to shove some big pipeline through and into some decent sized ports, this thing would explode. But that's against policy, and policy is hard to change. So that's presently in a in a down move there. And let me get on. I've got some questions. Thank you from you, Boyd, and from you, Helen. We might take a quick snapshot of the DX, but I do have to move on because I've got some very exciting stuff to show you, which will improve your lives considerably. I'll make a note of that. Boyd, if you'd shoot me an email, please, and James as well, anyone else that you want these sort of reviews, jneedham@thedanielcode.com. Just shoot me an email. Let me type it here for you. There you are, jneedham@thedanielcode.com. Shoot me an email, please, about anything you want covered, so I can prepare the charts for you before. And I'm always happy to talk about long-term charts. I think it's what we don't do enough of in our daily battles against the market. We need to look at these long-term charts to just get our perspective in mind. And we really need to do the same thing on currencies as well. The euro, which you've asked for, let's see if we can run through these pretty quickly. Here's DX. Helen, what's happening up there? Well, I'd said breaking its channel right now. Here's the last low. There's its trading channel, and we'll have to go to two at least. Yeah, so we've got to close against, we've got to close outside two standard deviations from the mean. And that bar closes on Tuesday. Unless there's some recovery pretty quickly, that means the trend has changed. And that market is then going to go sideways or further down. But we've certainly got preliminary evidence for change of trend there. And we should be revisiting this every couple of months to see what it's doing. But if that close is still below the two standard deviation when this bar ends on May the 12th, and it's not recovered almost instantly, we can assume with a high degree of confidence that the trend is down. Okay, the other one you wanted a snap look at was Euro for James, I think, and I'm putting this up because, I mean, this stuff is so dramatic, you don't actually see it. Look at this thing. This thing has just absolutely had the most dramatic collapse, and you just don't see enough of that on your daily chart. And we don't publish weekly charts anymore, which is a shame. There wasn't enough interest in them. But oh boy, you have a look what's happened to that, and it's a doozy. But just looking at it doesn't tell us more much. But James, if you would shoot me an email on that, please, and Boyd, you too. On US Canadian and Joe Schuster, you too. China and the Yuan, I can prepare the charts. I can get the four seal lines on them. I can get the trend chart, the Danico trading channels on them, and that gives a really strong idea of where they're going. So if you would just drop me a line when you think about that before the next webinar, I'll certainly do that for you. Okay, let me move on to something else if I can. Now, undoubtedly, we're going to run past time today. Those of you who are not interested in making money and want to leave a bit earlier, please feel free to. Those of you who are interested in making money, stick with me. This is what you're looking at. Your charts have changed now. This is UST bonds. I did this exercise with a client this week who I don't know if he's here, Dave. He's in UK, so the time is bad for him. He said he might be here, but he's not. He's a very nice doctor over there, Dr. Dave. We came to this chart because our typical 057 chart of T-bonds, we had this massive gap on the rollover to the new contract. The this is the June contract, and on this rollover, we had this massive gap, which destroyed this chart, excuse me, for any sort of analytical purpose. So what we do when that happens, you haven't I haven't talked to you about this before, is we go to this 067 chart, and this is what they call a back adjusted chart. With a back adjusted chart, they adjust the figures before the rollover to match the chart. So although this is the same chart, here's the rollover onto the June contract, but you can see it's been back adjusted to fit. And what is amazing is how extraordinarily accurate these things are, how quickly, within just a matter of days, these markets will realign themselves to be finding these Daniel code numbers and sequences again. And what I want to show you today, first of all, you can see there's a whole lot of 4S high and 4S low icons on this chart. And I indicated to you a few weeks ago that I've been doing a lot of work, years and years of work, in fact, to convert our full seal from the 6 and 12 day charts so it works on the daily charts. And you can see almost every one of these major turns, we've been able to find it as a fourth seal high or a fourth seal low. And in fact, I'll be teaching this at the tutorial in Los Angeles in a few weeks. Once you have that, I mean, almost literally, you can trade this four seals to four seal. There's the high, there's the low, there's the high, there's a little low, there's a high, there's a low, there's a high, there's a low, there's a high, there's a low. You get the picture. There's about $3,500 profit in this particular run of chart. We're starting from December, end of December. So we're 4 months and 8 days on a market that has a margin of 3,700 deposit margin, and it's earned about 30,000. So it's pretty exciting, very important. It's a market that's often overlooked, and but once you have these tools, it should all come alive for you, and I'm going to show you why. The studies you see at the bottom of the Daniel Code, Fast Stochastic, and the CCI, which I have adapted to make a momentum indicator. Both of these and other studies are available in the Daniel Code library, and they're free to all Daniel Code subscribers. If you don't already have these studies on your chart, please send an email to Terry, and he'll authorize them and get them on your charts. But let's just do a bit of trading here and see what happens. We get we'll start here, we're now looking at three things to start with. We're looking at our four seal highs and lows in particular, but we are also looking at the stochastic, our normal Daniel Code Fast Stochastic, and we are also looking at the CCI adjusted the way we have it in the Daniel Code library as a momentum indicator. You'll see the line, instead of having an overbought, oversold lines on the stochastic, I've simply got a line at 50%. So we're going to be much more fluid with it. When we get to this low here, you can see, looking at these indicators, we can identify that as a fourth seal low. Potentially, these lines, like everything in trading, these are support and resistance and probabilities. But the more studies, valid Daniel Code studies, I don't mean anything from anyone else, but more of our valid proven studies you can load on top, the evidence builds up to say this is going to be a valid signal. So you can see here your stochastic is well below the 50. We're happy to say that's a good place to buy. And if you look at the momentum indicator here, you can see that the chart has made a lower low, and that the momentum indicator has not. The momentum indicator says the bar before was a low, so this bar's made a lower low, but the momentum indicator has not, and that is divergence. And that's what we're looking for all the time. So we buy that, and off this guy runs up here, and he goes past the first, these blue lines I've put on. They've all been published. They're in your charts in the Daniel Code. Let me show you. There, this is the Daniel Code web page. You should be able to see it in a moment. There you are. And you'd go along through any of these. It's called the DC Chart Navigator. This chart happens to be under miscellaneous. You just get a drop down there, and you select T-bonds, and in a few seconds that chart will open up, and you'll see it has the blue lines on it, including where it is at the moment. Just closed a couple of ticks below 154.08. So that's how you get that stuff. So but you can see this is down here. There's the next line there, 153.02. Has updated that chart I just showed you, was from Wednesday night's update, and don't know if it has. Yes, it has. I'm looking at it now. The next line below 154.08 is 153.02, and 153.30 and 153.02. This market trades in 30 seconds. A tick is 1/32nd of a point. It's a lovely old-fashioned market that worked on the rule of eights. So I've put those numbers on the chart here, the blue lines, but you should all have seen those because they're on the website. So we start running up here. We get up to this bar here, and we get a sell signal where we can identify that top of that bar as a fourth seal high. We go down here, we find that our stochastic is overbought above the 50% we're treating now as suitable to sell, and we've certainly got divergence on our CCI. You can see how it's fallen away. There was the momentum high, 1-2. On that bar, we've got divergence on the CCI, and that tells us to sell it. And we try to sell it, and we get an inside bar, and nothing happens. Now, inside bars, you can treat them as a null or a void. In other words, what they usually are is the market marking time. It's waiting to find its time cycle. That's the most common reason for inside bars. And you can treat them as a null, which means you can extend the validity of the signal by one period. So we can still use the sell signal the next day, and we're short into that market. We don't have a buy because we're way up here in our stochastic, and this is where you start to use your Daniel Code trading channel. So we've got up to here on the trading channel. We can't take it any further because this is our last bar. And the very least we can say is the trend is up. The trading channel is pointing up, and it's pointing up dramatically. Now, this may not even be a valid trading channel at this stage because we don't have contact with two bars, and we can then, if you prefer, we can ask it to extend both ways, and we will want to have this upper one as it moves along hooking up to this high here. So not only if we don't have a nice reaction as we move along the trading channel, we go to the last reaction before the low. But the very least we can say is this market is in a high-speed trend, and in the high-speed trend you use your 1 to 3 day pullback rule. And I've been over this with you many times. Once you know this is in a high-speed trend, you can say 1 day down, 2 days down, and without regard to anything else, you can say the probability is that the trend will reassert itself. That's what usually happens in a fast trend, and off you go. You've had nice recognition at this blue line of 162. This market closed almost on at this bar. So we're happy with that setup, and we've got the start of using our trading channel tells us we're in a high-speed move, which means the market in a dynamic trend will not retrace more than 3 days. So for 1 to 3 days after a signal against the trend is elected, we look for the trend to reassert itself in the original direction, which means we buy that high and we're long again. And this market moves up and moves up, and eventually it gets to this blue line here at 166.17. And it closes, remember, target recognition in the Daniel Code numbers is either at a bar high low or on the close. And this market closes exactly at 166.17. We've got perfect price recognition, and we've got a fourth seal aligned there. And we look at what's happening down here. We say, well, our stochastic's above 50. We've certainly got divergence. The momentum indicator slipping away. We've got to sell this guy. The next day, we get a big reversal bar. That's actually a key reversal bar. The market opened within the range, made a new high for the move, closed below its open and below the previous close. That's the definition of a key reversal bar, and they are generally short-term momentum indicators. So we've got to sell that guy, and we get short right in here. We then have a look at that. We don't have a buy signal. We can't buy the next day, so we sit on that, and we couldn't buy because our stochastic was too high. We get one day up, which we don't really know what to do with, so we sit tight. We get one day down, and then we get a big push down into this low, which we recognize as being a fourth seal low. But we can't buy it because something's missing. If you look at the stochastic, which is this blue and red fellow here, the fast part of that stochastic, which is called percent K, is below, let's see how we're going with our numbers. Nearly of you are still here, so I guess you'd like to see this a bit. But we are going to run over time with it, folks, but it's really worthwhile, I promise you. So we get that low there, and the stochastic is in the right place to buy it. We know it, we can identify it's a fourth seal low. We don't have any price recognition, which is a bit of a worry. But more importantly, if you look at this momentum indicator, the market made a new low for the move, and so did the momentum indicator. So we have no reason to buy that. The market charges up nicely, and we're not with it. We missed this part of the move up, but we just move along anyway. We're trading a number of markets, so that's certainly not going to concern us greatly. We've made a nice lot of money on the roof, and we've got about 90% of it. Now we get to this bar, which is January the 30th. We run right into the Daniel Code blue line, 167.10. That switches on our antenna like crazy. We can identify that as a fourth seal high, which means that is a potential high. Gives us more comfort, much more comfort, to sell that. We go and look at our indicators. Stochastics are well above 50, and the momentum indicator is slipping away. There's the momentum high, two bars before at 133.33. This one is now at 117. It's less. So the market's made a new high for the move, and the momentum indicator has not, and that's our definition not being supported. So we've got divergence there. So we sell that. Nothing happens on the inside bar. The next day we sell it. We get short, and the market runs down pretty nicely. We're happy with this. It's running away. Then we get a key reversal bar, and we have a look at that. Our two indicators, we have good price recognition. We had perfect price recognition at this bar. You guys keep looking at this line along here. We'll tell you where these prices are. We had perfect recognition there. We had a low of 164.14 against the other side of the Daniel Code blue line. You see what's happening? It ran through that blue line a bit on the way up, and now it's testing it from the other side. So you can leave these blue lines on. You'll often find that they're used again from the other side. So 164.12 is being used there. We've got good price recognition. We get a little break and a key reversal bar here. Excuse me. We have to buy that high. Everything else lines up. We buy it, and the market goes down, and we're underwater. By this time, we can put on our Daniel Code trading channel, which is what this is all about. We start it from this high here, and we run it down. and we can only go to this bar. That's all the information we've got so far. But what we can see is this trading channel is really down and down hard. If this continues to be held, which is always the probability, then we're going to have a fast move down. And the least we can say is on the current evidence available to us, this market is starting a fast trend down. And if it's a fast trend, it will not correct more than 1 to 3 days. There's one day up, we've got to sell that low. And down it goes and down it goes and so on. And you can see as this moves along and matures, it will open up a bit. And we need to keep contact with 2 points. There's one, there's two. So this is a valid Daniel Code trading channel. If you don't stick to these rules, you'll finish up with a regression channel that just goes anywhere. A regression channel, which is what this tool is called, is quite useless to traders because it just will fill any pattern available. Whereas the Daniel Code trading channel has strict rules to it. Need to use these tools much more. Okay, so there's the low. There's a nice force seal low. Same story. I hope this is getting repetitious because it is. The stochastics well below 50. We've got huge divergence in the momentum indicator. We buy that and it runs straight up to this number up here, which is fine. And that'll be a Daniel Code retracement number. Same thing. We've got contract rollover because we're on the 067 chart, it doesn't affect us greatly, if at all. The back adjustment has happened, but the patterns are still valid. So we're well overbought. We've got huge divergence. We know that's a potential force seal high, and it's at a Daniel Code number. We sell it, and down it goes all the way. So that's pretty good. Now, one of the things that you'll see here, let me take these off, is you'll see that I've put on this thing for swings. Now, this is pretty basic. You find it under this toolbar here. If you haven't got it on your charts, you should. And it's under the heading indicators. And it's just called swings. And you should have this on all of your charts. And I'm going to show you why. Let's run down a bit here. It's called swing points. And you add that to your chart, and you can have all sorts of different settings to it. And what I want the major swings. I know that there are lots of other little swings. There's a swing there. There's a swing there. There's a swing there. There's a swing there. I'm not interested in those. I'm interested in the swings that have six bars either side of them, because they're the swings to which I'm going to draw my retracements. I don't think many of you people are doing this carefully enough, and hopefully you'll see from this that it is vital. So there's our first swing. You can see the swing lines tell us that's the first swing. So we can go to our little fella down here, our Dan icon. If you don't have him, let Terry know, and we'll give you the Daniel Code library. And now we can put on here the retracement. So that's a low, and we're going to buy that. And up it goes, and this market here, this bar closes at 156.17. It closes at 158.16. The Daniel Code number it's looking for is 158.17. So we've got perfect recognition of these retracements, which, as you know, are not your Fibonacci numbers or anything else. They are unique to the Daniel Code, and the way that these numbers control markets should stagger you. Here's the next bar up, and its high is 159.24. The next number up in the Daniel Code retracement is 159.24. You can see it on the chart. It's perfect. Now we finally get to a bar that has a force seal high on it, and it doesn't quite get to the next number, which is telling us this market is a little weaker, and we have to sell that. We've got our stochastic well above 50. We've got divergence on our CCI, and we have to sell that. So we sell that, and it comes down into this bar, which then immediately gives you a fourth seal low. Now, there's some other indicators that are not on this chart that make this a lot easier to see. They're reserved for people who do tutorials, but I can tell you that there's another coloured indicator that's blaring at that bar. But You've already got the tools. You've got nearly all these tools. This is the stage we put our trade channel on, and we can only go this far. And we can say immediately, this market is in at this stage a fast trending upward move, which means that 1 to 3 bars will be the only corrections it has, and we expect that the trend will be resumed. And that's exactly what happens. You buy that bar. It doesn't set up with our studies, but it sets up because we've identified that this is probably a fast trend, and in fast trends, market only retrace 1 to 3 bars. So that's it. Off it goes up to the top where we get the four seal high, and it keeps going. Once we get through this swing, we then have to use the other swing, which is this big swing up to here. So we put this retracement tool on now, and we pull this across to give us the area we want, and we can see it's hit that one, it's hit that one, it's done nothing there, it's flopped about, but this bar here has certainly found support from the other side. It goes straight through the next one, and then it goes right up, whack, and it hits the 164.04. In fact, the high of that bar, if you're still looking at the little banner across the top, is 164.04. It's perfect. We now need to add the last one, which is the 89, the black line that the famous black line that David Webb has used to such great effect. And we find by the time we get up here, we've got an attack on the black line, which has been reversed and turned it away. We have to sell that. Everything's set up for us here. The stochastic's overbought. Momentum is falling away, and we sell it. Now we can extend this up here. We're up to this bar here. And pretty clearly, we're still in a fast trend. This trend is up to here now. We've got a fast trend going up. We've got a breakout below it, which probably means it's going to fail, but it hasn't yet. We get an immediate recovery. And if this tells us it's in a fast trend, the market will not correct more than 1 to 3 bars. And we don't count inside bars, which are just filling in time, waiting for the time cycles to mature. So there's one. There's two. We have to buy it. We're long here. And this bar closes just above 165.13. And that's target recognition. Remember, we're looking for either the bar high low or the close. In the black line, the close is more important. We get a close at 165, 166. So 165.31 we're looking for. 32 ticks in a market. Add one tick, it gets to 166, which is exactly the close. And that sets up the sell, which takes a couple of days to materialize. You get this down bar. Then you get this up bar, which is identified as a four seal high. You sell that and away it goes. And the same thing happens down here. You buy this, it goes up, you put your trading channel on it, and you will see by the time we get there that you will say this market is in a downtrend. If it's a downtrend, it will not rally more than 3 days. In fact, it only rallies one. You want to sell it, and it wanders down, and eventually you finish up with this really, really good trend channel all the way down there. And it goes down finding precise, look at the way it just hits all these Daniel Code numbers that it goes, either at the low or at the close. That one's at the close, this one's at the low. This rushes through and hits the bottom of the trading channel. This rushes through, and here's your last number, 153.02. We had a perfect setup to buy this bar, except we didn't have price recognition, but we could identify that low as a four seal low. So I'm going to stop there, folks, because I've gone 15 or 20 minutes over time. We could do this again if you're interested in this. You have all of these tools now. I haven't used anything that's not in the Daniel Code library. You should be able to do this. And on this chart alone, it's run out $60,000, sorry, $30,000 on a $3,700 margin. So this is the proper way of Daniel Code trading. We can make it better and easier by stuff you'll learn at tutorials. But that's just what you've got now. You've got all those tools. You haven't got the four steel highs and lows. They're tutorial material at this stage, but I'm working on how I can add those to show you at the website, because they just are so valuable, as you can see. So that's where we are for the moment, guys. Let's see what we've got here for questions and comments. Everyone stayed with us. We've still got, I think we've only lost about three people, so you must have enjoyed that, which is great. I love that stuff. You know, you just got to be so excited about this when you get it, when you're putting in the work and you're seeing what I'm seeing. This stuff really is extraordinary, and I suggest that very few of you do it, but I'd like you to do it, and I'd like to help you do it. We must find ways to do that more and more. Okay, so where were we up to? We've talked to Helen about the DX. We've got Akshay, 30-year US dollar bond, US dollar. Akshay, shoot me an email. You've seen it being a long-term Daniel Code guy. I've got a very, very long-term US 30-year chart, which you have seen, and it's pretty dramatic. It's on the other computer, so I'll have to get it across to this computer to show you. But we'll have another, let's see where we are. We'll have another webinar. Look at this, guys. Gosh, time runs on like you wouldn't believe. I'm leaving for the States on the 24th of May, which is 2 weeks and a couple of days. And we're going to do another webinar on the 28th of May, which is going to be during the tutorial, the Daniel Code tutorial at Los Angeles. I'm going to release the new Fractalian program there and teach our tutorial folks how to get the most out of that. But I'm also going to release a cut down version to all of you, so you can start your trials and start thinking about how you select the best markets to trade. And I've got something to show you on that, but that'll be probably next week. I normally do webinars every 2 weeks, but the 2 weeks might be a bit late. But anyway, watch for the next webinar. It'll either be next Thursday or the following one, because then the big one will be while I'm in LA doing that tutorial. Okay, Lean Hogs, Leonardo, if you send me an email, I'll have the absolute answer for you, mate. Matty Corbett, nice to see you. Sage, what angle would you consider it to no longer be a fast trend on the DC trading channel, from Daryl? Let's have a look. That's fast. That's not. I want to see, I guess, it'll be a Daniel Code number, won't it? I want to see 37 and a half or better, don't I? I think that's the answer you're looking for, Daryl. Tony D, long-term T-bonds. Yeah, no, I can't email it to you, Tony, but I will have it for the next webinar. I promise you. Actually, you've missed gold. We did gold, it's just consolidating now with a couple of pretty important key numbers underneath it. You'll see that this webinar actually will be posted in a day or two, and you'll be able to see it, our summary of gold on the long-term charts then. So that's it, folks. Thank you so much for staying with us so long today. It's terrific. Here's Chip. Hi, mate. Moonbeams. Well, these are moonbeams, aren't they? Lunar phrases. Yeah, doing that. And we're going to teach you all of that, Chip, in some detail at the El Segundo tutorial, which you're coming to with your mate. And I'm going to show you how to create all this stuff for yourself, which would be fantastic. Lean Hogs, a skinny type of Harley Sage. I think you're obsessed. All right. Thank you, folks. MSN, thanks for your comments, folks. Glad you're enjoying it. I will likely get with you next week. If not, it'll be the Thursday after. But don't forget, put it in your diary. Those of you who are not coming to the tutorial, we'll do a webinar from the tutorial on the 28th. I'll show you I'll show you fractalians to do it yourself, Leonardo. Yes, there are there's a space left at the tutorial. Our good friend Dave O'Brien, who's a London doctor, was unable to change around his scheduling, his leave scheduling. He was booked to come, and then when I changed the date to 26 to 28, he found that he couldn't do that because they wouldn't have enough partners at his medical practice to keep going. So he's dropped out. So we do have that vacancy. If you'd like to come, shoot me an email, and we'd be delighted to have you. You'll just learn a great deal. Janet, Rivette, I've been trying to send you an email for the last 5 months to say welcome back to the Daniel Code, and why don't you come down to Los Angeles and have a drink and upgrade your skills at the tutorial. But most of all, I'd like to see you personally because you're a lovely lady. And we had great fun together at the other tutorials. I haven't seen you for a long time, and my emails keep getting bounced back. So if you have another email that I should be writing to you at, let me know, please. There it is. Right. I'll shoot your line, Janet, but do try and come down to Los Angeles. We've only got one lady in Los Angeles, folks, and that's Timmy. We need some more ladies in, otherwise it's going to be boring. So Janet, you're my pick. Get down there. I'll shoot you an email. Anyone else too? Girls in particular. Head for LA. End of the month. Be lovely. Be wonderful to have you. Some more ladies down there. We always have great fun at these tutorials, and having some girls around always makes the environment much better, and also keeps the bad language to a minimum after about the 50th Bloody Mary. Anyway, lovely to see you all, folks. It's great, and thank you for your attendance. I'm going to end this now, and look forward to seeing you soon. So, yes, you, Leonardo, send me an email. jneedham@thedanielcode.com, and I will send you all the guff on the tutorial chip. Looking forward to seeing you soon, and I'm going to try and talk Janet into coming down. She's a great lady. All right, we'll see you guys. Thank you. We'll see you at the next tutorial, at the next webinar, and hopefully at the tutorial. Thanks for being here today, and bye bye.